Hello and welcome to another edition of Motor Cars Enthusiasts. Right off the bat on today's show, Koenigsegg is in the news. Apparently the Koenigsegg folks, Christian von Koenigsegg and his group, has been crunching the numbers over the past several months after the claims of one Elon Musk and the brand new Tesla Roadster. And apparently Koenigsegg has come to the realization that these numbers are legit and this vehicle is real. And he wants to jump in the fight, basically building a Tesla Roadster fighter. Yes, if you watch this show only even a tiny bit, you know that I absolutely love it when manufacturers want to go head-to-head with each other. So, cannot wait to see what the Koenigsegg Group may have up their sleeve to go head-to-head with that Roadster. Next up on the list, an interesting machine from the folks over at Audi. A little bit of a last hurrah, if you will. It's the brand new Audi A4 Ultra Sport Edition. Now, this particular machine is exclusive for the United States. The only way you'd be able to find this particular vehicle. And it's exclusively in this quantum gray color. You can't even get this vehicle in a different color. It also comes with these 5-spoke 19-inch alloy wheels that are bespoke to this vehicle, along with a bunch of S model trim, including black optic trim and a little bit of RS4 trim carbon on the inside, including some carbon fiber mirror caps and a small carbon fiber spoiler out back. The vehicle, as far as the power is concerned, comes from a 2-liter engine making 252 horsepower. Sliding up behind that engine is a manual transmission. And that's where the real story actually lies. This is the last ever manual transmission vehicle that Audi will have on offer here in the United States. And they're only going to build 40 of these. And apparently they're already here stateside, just waiting to get pricing and heading to brand new dealerships. So if you are a big Audi fan and you love having 3 pedals in the footwells, this is the last go-round of a brand new machine you can get from Audi anywhere inside of their vehicle range. I'm assuming the only thing you could probably get it maybe is in an R8, but they may even be killing that off as well. We'll have to wait and see on that front. So the brand new Ultra Sport Edition will be available in dealers very shortly. Next up on the list, Richard Hammond is in the news. Ex-presenter of Top Gear and current presenter of The Grand Tour on Amazon. And apparently, Mr. Hammond and his family went through a tad bit of a scary situation over the past month or so. It happened in a French villa in the south of France where they were actually staying, not only Richard, but also his wife Mindy and 15 other people in his party, including his children. And apparently some bandits actually broke into the house, put some acidic gas inside of the ventilation system, effectively knocking everyone unconscious. And then they went through the house full bore, because when the Hammond group actually woke up the next morning to find doors wide open, to find bags and purses and the like gone through, the house basically ransacked, all the jewelry and cash was actually taken from the villa itself. Now, thanks to closed circuit television, they were actually caught on camera, and these folks, those being the bandits, were actually caught in just a handful of days later. But it's still kind of a scary story and something that apparently happens a fair amount in that part of France, sad to say, because world champion Formula One driver Jenson Button apparently had a similar situation in a similar part of France back in 2011. But thankfully everybody's okay, so nobody was harmed in this particular situation. Last up on the list, this is probably one of the most intriguing stories I've done all year. And it kind of involves around the Chevrolet Cruze, even though it doesn't have anything to do with General Motors. It doesn't have anything to do with Chevrolet. It doesn't have anything to do with the Cruze, other than a very small bit. Involving a 25-year-old young man from Canada. This young man purchased one of these brand new Cruzes and took it on down to his insurance company office to get the thing insured, where promptly he was told, thanks to a handful of accidents and a handful of tickets, that it was going to cost him the small sum of $3,400 a year to insure his brand new ride, where he blurted out, well, what would it cost if you were a female? just like here in the United States, it is a fair amount cheaper, basically because us guys are kind of hooligans, to actually insure a woman here in the United States, just like it does in Canada. And he was told that it would cost him only $2,600 if he was female. So what did this young man actually do? Well, he headed on down to his doctor's office, where he got a doctor's note claiming that from here on forth, he was going to identify himself as a woman. And then went on to the government entities inside of the country and got it done officially, where he's officially identifying himself as a woman. Then happily wandered on down to his insurance company to collect the discount he so desired on his brand new ride. Now, because the media has hit this, he's obviously in backpedal mode, where he has said that in no way, shape, or form is he making fun or making light of anybody in that transition period or possibly wanting to identify themselves as something other than what they were born as. Like me, I don't want to make light of anybody in this situation. But you have to say, is this offensive, this story being? Or is it borderline genius? I would love to know what you may think down in the comments section. And that's all there was that I thought was worth talking about for this edition of Motor Cars Enthusiasts. Don't forget to like us over on the Facebook page. Links down in the show notes. Also, if you'd like to subscribe to the channel, you can do so at any time and get the first dibs on the brand new show as soon as they come out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again real soon.